Hey guys, how's it going? I hope you're having a great week. It's about to get better because I've got an awesome Photoshop tutorial for you right here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to turn a photograph into text. It's a really cool effect. All right, are you ready? We're going to take this portrait and we're going to cover it with text and turn the portrait into text so it looks like it's actually made out of text. It's a really cool tutorial. It's not that hard. Just follow along step by step. So without further ado, let's get rid of my face and let's look at the screen and jump into the tutorial. So what we're going to do this week is we're going to take this photograph and we're going to turn it into text. And this is a real fun effect, and it's actually not that hard to do. So here we go. We're just going to start with a photo. Whoever you want to use, guy or girl, take the photo yourself or just grab it from Fotolia or Adobe Stock, which is where I got it, or one of the free stock sites out there. So what we're going to do now is with the photo selected, we're going to create a paragraph for text. So we're going to grab our type tool, and that would be the T key, by the way. And we're just going to click and drag around the area. In fact, let's just go around the whole image there with that type tool. And now what we've done is we've created a type area that fills the whole photo. Now, what you want to do is grab a bold font, like say Arial Bold, what we've got here. And this is at 4 points. It's really small. The other thing you want to do too is make sure that your leading here is also set very small to about 4. So we're going to just keep it really, really small and tight. Now, if you're on CC and you want some type, you can just go under type here and grab paste lorem ipsum. And you'd have to do that a few times to paste all this text. The other thing you could do is just go to a website and just grab some text. Now, there's other sites out there. There's lorem ipsum generators, and some of them are real fun. My favorite is the Samuel Jackson one. You might want to do a search for that. It's kind of fun. And just cut and paste some text. Once you've done that, we're just going to paste it in. So I'm just going to paste this in a few times and just cover this with text. All right, perfect. So I'm just going to just click the move tool. So what we've got right now is our photograph with some text over the top. So we're actually going to get rid of the photograph and make this text the photo. So we're going to have fun with that. So what we're going to do is we're going to hide that for now. Now, what we want to do is we want to grab a luminosity mask, but we're probably going to grab it from the blue channel. What does all that mean? Well, we're going to select our image, our background image. We're going to go to the channels and look for the channel that has most contrast. Usually it's the blue. Let's have a look. We've got the red there. We've got the green and we've got the blue. You know, the green's not bad too, but I like the blue. It's just got a little bit more of what we need. So I'm just going to hit Control key or Command key and click on that thumbnail. And then what it's going to do is it's actually going to load the selection. So we've got the selection there. However, notice that it's kind of marching around the edges there. We actually want to invert that selection. So you could hit Command Shift I or go under Select and then just choose Inverse Selection, which we can see right here, just the inverse. There we go. Command-Shift-I or Control-Shift-I. And now we've got a selection just around the face of our person. Excellent. Now what we want to do is click back on the RGB right beside the thumbnail, and that turns on all the channels. You want to make sure all the channels are on before you go back to layers, otherwise you could get in a whole pile of trouble and not realize what's going on. We've all done it. Don't feel bad if it happens to you. All right, so we're going to go to the layers panel now. So what we're going to do now is we're going to turn on our text layer and click on our text layer now with the selection still active. So what we're looking to do now is I want to create a mask just for that text. So we're going to go down and click the layer mask and boom, we've got our layer mask. So what we need to do though is before we go in and then just play around with this, there's a couple of things we need to do. One of them, notice that this is locked, so we can just click there to unlock it. You could double click it and hit enter if you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, and we're just going to drag that above our type layer and turn it off for now. All right, so we've got our type layer here. We can't really see it well, so maybe we'll just create a layer with white. So we're going to create a new layer here, and I'm just going to click the new layer icon there and fill it with white. That's option backspace and just drag it to the bottom. Perfect. All right, this is starting to look good. So we're getting very close. What I'd like to do though is add some color now. So what we're going to do is take the color from our image. So let's turn our image on and we're going to turn it into color blend mode. And now we can see just the color is showing. All right, we're getting very close. The next thing we want to do is we want to boost the contrast a little bit. So we're going to create some curves at the top here. So let's go down. We're going to grab our curves. And with our curves active, we're just going to muck around with this a little bit, move some things around until we see some contrast. And we're just going to drag that around. Let's just kind of drop down the shadows a little and play around with the highlights just a little bit. Not bad. And just kind of play around until it gets, if you want a really, really strong, go this way. But probably not so much. I want to have a little bit of shading going on in there. So I'm just increasing the contrast and creating a contrast adjustment. I'm pretty happy with that. Let's see that before and after. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. And notice as we're doing that, let's play around just a little bit more. It's kind of cleaning out some of that stray stuff I had in the background. So that's looking good. The other thing you can do too is actually go into the mask here, and we've selected that mask, and we can actually do some tweaking in the mask itself and play around with the contrast. So what we're going to do is apply a curve adjustment directly here inside the mask. And you're just going to hit Control M or Command M, and the curves are going to pop up. We're not doing an adjustment layer because we're actually adjusting the mask. And you may or may not make the adjustments, but let's have a look. Let's just tweak it and see if it's going to help us a little bit. Not liking it that way, but if we go that way, it's kind of interesting. Okay, what about in the highlights? So you can see here, we can just really kind of just play around in our curves here and sculpt this image, or we could even just click that to reduce it. Oh, by the way, if you want to learn how to use curves, I have a great tutorial video, free video on curves, and just click on the link and you can check it out. So let's have a look here. I'm just kind of playing around with this a little bit, just looking for something, give me a little bit of contrast. I'm kind of digging that a little bit, and we're just going to click OK. So I think we've tweaked it a little bit. All right, so there's another thing we want to do. This is the last step. What we're going to do is take this layer here with our original image, and we're going to duplicate it. Now, you can duplicate it by dragging it right here into the new layer icon, or hitting Control or Command J. That will also do the same thing. So what we're going to do now is we're going to drag this to the very top. Right now, it looks kind of weird, but we're going to change the blend mode of this to Linear Burn. I've tried a lot of different blend modes, and this just seems to work really well for what we're doing. We're going to drop our opacity way low, drop it up, bring it up to maybe around about 13%. And you can see how that's just bringing back a little bit more detail. So we started with that, we went to here. Now, the other thing you could do with this is actually just create a mask. So I'm going to hit the Option key. So what we're going to do is hold down Option and create the mask. And that would be Alter Option. What it does is it creates an inverted mask. So now, rather than having that, you know, stronger stuff everywhere, we can just apply it where we want. So I'm going to grab a white brush. So grab your brush. Make sure it's a nice soft edge brush, hardness all the way down. Wipe for the foreground color. I've got the opacity turned down to 46. I'm going to turn it all the way up here, though, because why not in this case? Because we've already turned the opacity down on the layer. The other option you could do is just turn the opacity all the way up on the layer. And now turn the opacity down on the brush. Maybe this is a better option. So what we're going to do is just go here. And now we're just going to kind of paint around the areas that we want to show a little more detail. Like maybe just around the face there. And maybe a little bit around the neck. So just around there. Okay, cool. Now obviously it's a little much. So what we're going to do is just drop our opacity down now until it gets to what we want it to be. So I'm going to give it just a small amount of opacity. Right now we're about 36% there, and I'm just going to give it just a little touch there on the eyes, and you know, more or less, let me bring this curve out to the top here. No, don't like that, just an experiment. Sometimes you can experiment with some different things if you want to push a little more contrast in here. So what we could do just to finish this off is maybe put an adjustment layer on top. So let's grab an adjustment layer, let's try some levels and just see what this looks like. All right, so we've got some levels here. We want to darken the blacks. Just pull that in a little bit, see how we can do that. And if you want to brighten the whites, you can also do that there. So you can go into mids and just kind of tweak it. So what I'm doing is just tweaking this just to get a final result. Pretty happy with that. And I'm just going to drop it back in there. And if you zoom in at 100%, you can see there's the type. And notice now that this portrait is now made out of text. Hey. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'm going to make a new one every week. And in fact, I've got a whole ton of great videos coming down the road, and I'd love to share them with you. But there's only one way I can do that, and that's if you hit that subscribe button right now. It's big, it's huge, it's ugly, it's right there. That big, ugly red button is worse than an As Seen on TV button. Hit it right now, you become a subscriber, and you will subscribe to awesomeness. No rainbows and unicorns, but I'll give you a free Photoshop tutorial each week. And while you're at it, do us a favor, add a comment down below. Tell me what you like, what you'd like to learn. And also, if you've got any questions, you know, ask questions about Photoshop, Lightroom, photography, drones, even ask some personal questions, but not too personal. But go ahead. I check those comments. I read them all, except for the ones from the trolls. I try not to read them, but I do, and they get to me. But I'm getting thicker skin. So add your comments. Love to read them. And I'd love to share exactly what you'd like to see me sharing and learn what you'd like to learn. So anyway, hit that little like button there, show a little like love, and if you haven't done it yet, you know what I'm going to say. Yep, hit that subscribe button, because if you do, I'll love you, you'll be awesome, and you'll see my beautiful face every week, and you'll get a new Photoshop tutorial, which I know you're probably going to love the tutorial a lot more than looking at my face, but, you know, hey, it's a free bonus. All right, thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.